This would be pretty much. So let's begin with some of the fundamentals of Hilbert space. A for every A in X. This is this infimum, what I mean by the best approximation. So see, if I can really find a point in A, okay, for which the distance between this point X and set A is equal to distance between the point X and the point of A, the fixed point of A, you call such a small a as the best approximation of it, the minimizer basically of it. So here's the definition, the key definition that we like to have, that if I can find an A in A that kind of realizes, okay, this distance BXA, and what does it mean? That the distance between X and A is equal to the distance between that X and that fixed point, basically. Okay. In other words, roughly. So you see that you have these numbers, and you're taking their infimums. So it's not necessary that its infimum should also be of this format. So if the infimum is also of this form, okay, in other words, I can find an A in A, okay, for which the distance between X and the set A is equal to what? Distance between X and that element A, fixed element A, then you're going to say that basically, that this small a is what you call the best approximation of x and a. Then this small a, okay, is best approximation. Okay, that's it. Best approximation of x. So we're going to do some examples, and now this notion of this best approximation basically are kind of minimizer, we're going to rename it basically soon, okay, is of very importance in practical sense actually. So what essentially, you know, in some of the situation you want to know is that imagine you have a physical system, any physical system, and you want to estimate the smallest possible energy that physical system can exert at. And that, you know, what you call it, solve that problem basically, when you formulate it, it breaks down that finding what you call the smallest energy, okay, roughly, of a physical system turns out to basically, you know, finding the best approximation actually under the minimum norm actually. Okay. So this has lots of mathematical importance, obviously, but like this also has physical importance from the application point of view. Okay. Now the next thing that I would like to talk and make it kind of more precise is this. Mark that the best approximation maps A onto this is X A, which is going to be obviously a map from A to what? To A plus. Okay. I hope that like it's really evident basically from the definition that if a point A is kind of a best approximation of X in A, you can achieve this A by minimizing this function, actually. This is precisely that we're doing here. Okay? So what you want to do is basically you want to minimize these numbers. Okay? And if this minimization exists, this minimizer exists, minimizer of such a function like this, you're going to call that as the best approximation, actually, I guess. So it's just the reformulation of what you said previously. Let's do some examples, basically. I'm going to essentially do three examples. In one case, when the minimizer exists, actually. Obviously, you can ask the question, for a given metric and a given set and a given point, can we always find a minimizer? In other words, can we always find a best approximation A to X, actually? The answer is not necessarily. Okay? There are certain conditions, actually, that must be satisfied to guarantee that you can always find a minimizer. Okay? But, here I'm going to do roughly the three examples. Number one, that when the minimizer exists. Number one, second would be that when minimizer does not exist. The third would be that the minimizer exists, but it's not unique actually. Okay. By minimizer, I mean best approximation. Okay. Just kind of minimizes this distance function. Okay. So let's do some examples. Here's the first example. Okay. So I hope that you remember this. When this distance is going to be zero?
X belongs to
what we call. So this is what that we know actually. So outside a closure A, we cannot have best approximation. Why not? We can't have a best approximation. Why can't we have a minimum that we cannot have best approximation? Because zero, approximation has to satisfy what? So the best approximation is that, basically, that the best approximation of x in A should be what? Should be equal to the dxA. This is what by definition. So this must be true actually.
Equals to
zero. Okay.
X equals to A.
Exactly. So what does follows from here? That x must be equal to A, but this will throw x into the
A.
Which is a kind of a contradiction. That it should not be in A actually. So roughly what this example is showing, that if A is not closed, okay, then you can't have best approximations of the points which are not in, which are in the closure but not in A actually. Okay? Why? That if dxA is zero, then the best approximation is equal to, what do you call, the distance from that point, x to the potential candidate of A, and obviously this is going to imply that x and A must be same, which is going to throw A into the set A, which is not possible because, you know, which is not possible because in this case the x will enter into the A, which is a kind of a clear-cut contradiction to the, whatever you call, the assumption. So what does this example is showing, that if you have a metric space and you take a subset that is not closed, you can't find best approximation for the elements of such subset. Not elements, but those elements which are in closure but not in A. For such elements, you can't find best approximation. So roughly, what are this example is showing, that it's not necessary that you can always, you will be always able to find the best approximation.
Sir, other assumption
may be
that
would be x called a distance 0, maybe. Then we. Yes. Can you close the menu? So what essentially you are saying that, just pick a clue. In other words, its closure does not agree with the set itself actually. And take the part, take the points from the part which is not part of the air. Such points cannot be best approximated. So if a point is in closure, this must be true, whether you like it or not. That's an if and only if situation. So this example shows that it's not necessary to always find the best approximation. Essentially, what we are going to study in this chapter, the one-liner is this, that what are the key conditions that allow you to basically find the best approximations. That's what we like, especially in Hilbert spaces. Okay. So we want to find the best approximations in Hilbert spaces. non-uniqueness, I mean, let's do an example of non-uniqueness. In other words, I mean, sometimes it varies, but it's not necessarily unique. So for non-uniqueness, we have to take this particular example. Take E to be R2. Okay. And take one norm. On E. What do you mean by the one norm on E?
Some of epsilon.
Some of epsilon. Simple. You have an ordered pair, x, y, and you just simply sum out the absolutes. Now take the set of points. Okay. Maybe, you know, set of points would be essentially in straight line. Points that are maybe less like it. So A, the set A is basically a straight line. It's like a set formed by the straight line. Okay. That passes through. That passes through. Can we see straight line as a set? Okay. So we know that, but it's a sort of ordered pair such that, you know, h plus y equal to c, something like that. See straight line as a set. So I'm saying that you have a similar kind of a set, okay, that passes through some points, and those points are what? Very strange notation. Equal to R minus 1 minus 2. This will be simply a straight line. Okay. So how does it look like? Huh? So it must cross through region 1 minus 1 and minus 1 and 1, okay, then essentially what we are saying that if you take this x, okay, and compute its distance from this arbitrary point, you know, lambda and minus lambda, what you're gonna have, you're gonna have something interesting, which is, you know, 1 minus lambda and 4 plus lambda, which turns out to be, 2 again. The one norm of it. So it turns out to be 2 again. Now, what does this reflect? This reflects that these two basically agree not only for one fixed A, but for any fixed, any A, you know on this lambda, lambda minus lambda from the, so in other words, any such point A is going to be the best approximation to the x, because the dxA agrees with, what do you call it? The distance between x and A. So they both are equal for all such cases. This is what the definition. So what's the definition? The definition says that if you can find an A such that the distance between x and a agrees with that, you know, then you say that, okay, this a is a best approximation to x. Now, if this is happening for every single a in a, that means that every point of a is a best approximation to that point fixed. So, in other words, the best approximation is not unique, actually. So, the first example we kind of saw that it not necessarily exist, and secondly we saw that okay, if it exists it must be unique. So the real, you know, question would be that okay, what we should have in such a way that we should always, it's like it is kind of guaranteed that the, you know, best approximation to every point exists and it must be unique. For that, we would like to do a little theorem.
Sir, how does this turn out to be
2? How does it turn out to be
2? Sir, lambda is between minus 1 and 1. So 1 minus lambda is something non-negative. So the mod goes away in both cases.
So put answer that the lambda is between minus 1 and 1, the 1 minus lambda and 1 plus lambda are always going to be non-negative. So the mod goes away and lambda cancel. Anyway, so let's